guys, so today I am here to tell you all about the books I am most excited about coming out in 2019. So over the past few months I have been taking stock of books that have been popping up in my like peripheral vision that will be released in 2019 that I am eagerly anticipating. Some sequels of books I've already read and loved, and some just entirely new books that I can't wait to read. So without further ado, let's get into my most anticipated releases of 2019. So in completely random order, as I think of them, I will tell you about them, but I will try to put them in date order in the description box down below. So the first book I want to mention to you is Gingerbread by Helen Oyeyemi. This book is being published by Picador next year, and you might already know this, but I just love Helen Oyeyemi's writing style so much so that I would eagerly anticipate any book that she has coming out. It seems like there's a lot going on in this book. There's a mother and a daughter, the daughter of which attends a highly elite private school in London, and they are seen as quite aloof and strange and make the most incredible gingerbread. Not to mention that Harriet, the mother, has a long lost friend named Greta that seems to have had a big impact on her life, and her daughter has decided to try and seek this friend out, having heard so much about her. It sounds very surreal and odd, which is true of all of the Oyeyemi books I've read, and honestly I'm just there to gobble this one up because I adore her writing, and it sounds like there are elements of fairy tale inspiration behind this one, a bit like Boy Snowbird, so bring it on is all I'm saying. In terms of a sequel, however, I have to mention The Wicked King by Holly Black. This is a sequel to The Cruel Prince, which came out this year or the year before, but I read it this year and I really enjoyed it. It's a young adult fantasy novel, really discovering the darker side of the fae and travelling to the fae realm, where a couple of mortal girls were raised there along with their half-sibling, who is half fae as well, and trying to fit in with the kind of fae court and all the dark things that are going on in that place. And you know, a lot happened in that first book. Plenty of action, yet equally plenty of setup for a sequel. So I am so ready to find out what is next in store for our characters in book two. We then have A Thousand Ships by Natalie Haynes, which is so up my alley because it is a retelling of the Trojan War from the perspective of the female characters of myth that were involved in this story. So Natalie Haynes has previously written Greek myth retellings such as The Children of Jocasta, which I read and thoroughly enjoyed. I also recently read Pat Barker's retelling of Greek mythology, The Silence of the Girls, which focuses on the Trojan War, and this too focuses on the Trojan War, which is usually explored from the male perspective of the warriors, and I'm so pleased to see this kind of increase in exploration of the female experience of the Trojan War, and I cannot wait to read another book like that. And like I said, I already know I enjoy Natalie Haynes's writing. We then have a comic book, and that is Moonstruck Volume 2. So the second collected trade paperback volume of this comic book series comes out in 2019, and I can't wait because I loved the first comic book volume in this series. It is an incredibly diverse LGBTQ+ comic book series focusing on a group of characters who live in a world much like our own, except many people have magical abilities or are magical creatures and live alongside ordinary humans. And our protagonists are werewolves, centaurs, sorceresses, and various other interesting magical creatures. And it's so heartwarming. I adored the first in this series, loved the artwork, loved the character, loved the diversity of characters, and cannot wait for volume two. We then have An Orchestra of Minorities by Chigozie Obioma, and I don't know terribly much about this book except that it is based on Homer's Odyssey, and instantly if a book is in any way retelling or inspired by a Greek or Roman myth, I am there. And this one, like I said, is inspired by Homer's Odyssey, although I believe it is set, you know, in contemporary times, or at least in the past few decades as opposed to in antiquity. And you may know Chigozie Obioma from his previous book The Fisherman, which was shortlisted for the Man Booker Prize back in 2015. So I'm really excited to see what he does with this myth. We then have a book by an author I've never read before, but have to read this book by, and that is The Priory of the Orange Tree by Samantha Shannon. This is a high fantasy novel, and as the cover gives away, it features dragons. So count me there. I've also heard amazing things about this book as proof copies have been going round and I've been seeing people reviewing it. It's been getting a lot of buzz. The opening lines of the blurb read, "A world divided, a queendom without an heir," I like queendom instead of kingdom, "an ancient enemy awakens. The house of Berethnet has ruled Innes for 1,000 years. Still unwed, Queen Sabrin the Ninth must conceive a daughter to protect her realm from destruction, but assassins are getting closer to her door." And as well as Sabrin, there is Taine, who is a female dragon rider, and I'm interested to see how their stories intersect. We then have a collection of poetry by the wonderful Jen Campbell, who also has a BookTube channel that I'll link down below. But her poetry collection, The Girl Aquarium, is released in 2019. She has previously published a poetry pamphlet with the Rialto, but this is her first proper full collection. Not her first book though, because as you probably know, she's also published fiction for adults, children and non-fiction. But I have read Jen's pamphlet poetry collection from the Rialto and really enjoyed it, so I cannot wait for the full collection, The Girl Aquarium, to come out and for me to be able to gobble this one up, because I know I'm a big fan of Jen's poetry. It often touches on fairy tale themes and kind of picks apart modern issues and explores characters with deformity and queer characters, and I'm so excited to see all of that in one place. Another book by an author I'm already a fan of is Lanny by Max Porter. Max Porter previously wrote Grief is a Thing with Feathers, which is one of the most gorgeous, stunning books I've ever read, so I'm incredibly excited to see that he has a new book coming out. It's about a village on the outskirts of London that has a strange past history, and about the inhabitants of this village as odd things begin to happen. I need no more, given how much I enjoyed Max Porter's last book. Funnily enough, there's actually another book coming out in 2019 that I'm incredibly excited for, which is the next novel by a author that was shortlisted for the 2015 Man Booker Prize and in fact won it, and that is Marlon James' new book. Marlon James previously wrote The Brief History of Seven Killings, and his new book is quite different, as it's actually a high fantasy novel. It's called Black Leopard, Red Wolf, which is the first in the Dark Star trilogy. Again, I know I like this author, I know I love high fantasy, and I also have heard that this one is perhaps inspired in part by kind of African folklore, so it's a little bit different from a lot of the fantasy I have read in the past, which is often quite westernized, so I am really keen to get to this one. We then have another fantasy novel that is by an author I haven't read in this instance, and that is Crown of Feathers by Nikki Palpreto. This I am so intrigued by because it's something I've never read before in fantasy, and that is, it's about phoenix riders. So not dragon riders, not horse riders, but people that ride on the back of giant magical phoenixes. Give it to me now. Another comic book volume that is being updated in 2019 and coming out in trade paperback volume is the first volume of Nnedi Okorafor's new comic book series. Nnedi Okorafor is a science fiction and fantasy author that I adore, and I'm so excited to read this collaboration with artists that kind of brings her writing to a new genre. It's set in the same world as her Binti trilogy and is about aliens, physical aliens, as well as kind of non-American citizens immigrating to the United States of America, and it's a commentary on immigration as well as containing all of her awesome science fiction themes. If I didn't mention though, it's called LaGuardia, and I believe the first issue is out, but I personally prefer to read them in trade paperback, so can't wait for that. I then have to mention a sequel that I'm actually lucky enough to have a proof copy of already and can't wait to read, and that is The Curses by Laura Eve. This is a sequel to The Graces, which is a young adult, maybe fantasy, maybe paranormal series, that is that our main character in the first story goes to a new school and meets a new group of people, and these are three siblings everyone in the school is obsessed with because they think they are witches, and she kind of ingratiates herself into their friendship group, and it's about kind of uncovering the secrets of their family. Are they witches? Are they not witches? I cannot give that away. Spoilers, but I can't wait to see what happens in the second book because there was a lot of drama in book one and I really like the way this was written. I think it's great for fans of the film The Craft, so definitely check it out if you enjoyed that. There's also the second book in the Mirror Visitors series, which is actually already all out in French, but the translation into English of the second book comes out in 2019, translated by Europa Publishing, and this I believe is called The Missing of Claire de Lune. I read the first book in this series, which is called A Winter's Promise this year, very much enjoyed it, and I'm really looking forward to the sequel. If only my French was better, I just have to wait for them all to be published in English. But this is a fantasy series in like a world of different citadels where our protagonist Ophelia is sent to a different citadel for an arranged marriage that she doesn't really want to be involved in but has no choice over, and it turns out that she's being used as a political pawn and strange political games are going on in this new land, so it's all about what's going on there. Briefly, there is also In an Absent Dream by Seanan McGuire, which is the fourth in her Wayward children's novella series published by Tor, and I am currently listening to the third book in the series on audiobook on Scribd, and each one follows a kind of separate storyline but is about children and teenagers who have travelled through portals into fairy realms and then been sent back to our world and are finding it difficult to adjust. So I'm intrigued to see what book four is all about. And then there is also On the Come Up by Angie Thomas. Angie Thomas previously wrote The Hate U Give, which was a bestseller for good reason, and this is her latest standalone young adult book. It's about Bree, who dreams of becoming a world famous rapper. Her father was actually an underground rapper, but he died before he was able to hit it big, and she's hoping of kind of like, you know, surpassing what he managed and kind of changing her life through rap. In the midst of all of this, there is the hardship of working class life in America. Her mum has lost her job, they are having to use food banks, and it's kind of exploring what real people are going through right now in loads of countries, including my own. And it really just sounds like another really important book from Angie Thomas. But lastly, I want to mention a book that doesn't even have a cover yet, but you know I'm excited for it because it's the latest book by Julia Marillier, and that is Harp of Kings, which will be the first in her Warrior Bards series. This is a new series that is starting in 2019, and I believe is kind of set in the same world as Seven Waters and Blackthorn and Grimm, which are two of her other series, although the stories don't interconnect, but they're all set in this kind of medieval Ireland that interact with the Fae. And honestly, just, you know, I have not finished Juliette Marillier's back catalogue, but that's fine because I don't want to ever have no Juliette Marillier to read, but I am still excited that she is publishing a new book that I can add to my TBR. So those are all the books at the moment I'm super excited for coming out. I would love to know what books you're excited for coming out in 2019, and I'm sure there will be more that I learn of just from your recommendations, but also as the year goes on and new books are announced. Let me know if you have thoughts on any of the books I've mentioned in this video, and until next time, happy reading. I'll see you again soon. Bye guys.